This is Adam from AFC Energy. Adam is the CEO of AFC Energy, and they are offering a hydrogen solution for cars. Adam, thanks for taking the time to talk to us today for a few minutes. Tell me a little bit about where you're planning to put this product.
Sure, the actual EV charging unit that we released or launched today is a very flexible product in the sense that it can be moved to a permanent location in a car park, in a fleet operator of vehicles for commercial reasons, or even sort of on temporary basis as to festivals or to sporting events where demand is not necessarily always requiring of an expensive upgrade to a grid. So it's very flexible, very transportable, sits on the back of a truck, and it's flexibility is part of its charm, I guess.
Are you thinking that it's a fuel cell for vehicle charging, or are there other uses in your mind then?
Sure, the fuel cell that we've been developing over the last 12 or so years has had a number of different, there are a number of different applications for that. The revolution, if you like, or the growth in EV charging has identified a very clear need for more localized generation of power and to be successful and to deliver on government's policy, probably needs to be able to fast track deployment quicker than what the local grids can deliver upgrades. And so partly what we're trying to do here is meet that demand in a fairly short time frame. It's very helpful.
And tell me a little bit about the vehicle charging that you think you can get to. Who are your customers then in the first instance once you release here?
Look, our customers, we're in discussions with a number of organisations that have approached us. As I said earlier, the fleet, car park operators, things like that, councils who've got a need for relatively quick deployment. So we've got quite a long list of potential customers. We're now starting to get into some of the more detail. I think today was the launch of the product that people can see for the first time. They can see how it operates. They can understand its relative simplicity and maintainability, which is important to getting public acceptance from our customers.
You said that it can run on low-grade hydrogen. Is that something that's much more accessible than better quality hydrogen as such?
Sure, I mean, hydrogen is available in a number of different forms or sources. The more pure the hydrogen is, the more expensive it comes, the more high cost of power is from the system. So our objective is really to try and drive down not only the cost of our equipment, but also the cost of the fuel. And hydrogen at a relatively low grade is certainly available through things such as cracking of ammonia. Ammonia is a readily available product. It has hydrogen within it, and so we're looking at different ways of utilising ammonia as part of our off-grid EV or just off-grid displacement of diesel in today's market.
And how does that affect cost to the end user then?
Look, I mean, ultra pure hydrogen is multiple times more expensive than lower grade hydrogen. So, we're looking to be cost competitive with diesel generators in the market today, and I guess also premium EV chargers.
Okay, great. And tell me a little bit about your kind of 10-year plan for the business. Then, where do you see, and how much do you see rolling out by 2030?
Look, it's a good question. I think the market for a decarbonised off-grid energy solution is growing by the day as we as a society adopt electrification as part of the mainstream of transportation and other sectors. So I think the growth in opportunity, particularly around EV applications, around displacement of diesel, stationary diesel gensets, those two, diesel gensets on their own is a $20 billion a year market. So for over the next 10 years, we're certainly looking to start deploying commercial products into that market and trying to capture start that transition or glide path from fossil to clean over the next 10 years.
Listening to this morning, talking about the kind of the paradigm and the shift, it seems like it's going to be a tough one. There's a huge energy requirement out there, and you think you can really help solve that problem shift of cars requiring huge amounts of energy quickly and availability.
Absolutely. I mean, we first announced the concept or the prototype of this back in January of this year, and From that release or that announcement, we were quite overawed in terms of how much interest there was, which led us very quickly to the decision that we have to try and capitalize on this market. The market, how big is the EV market? You know, we're in a couple of 100,000 vehicles on the road today in the UK. I think we're projecting something closer to 40 million over the next couple of decades, and that's just the UK alone. Investment in the UK infrastructure just to meet that demand is estimated to be somewhere north of £100 billion. The market is enormous. You know, renewables have a role to play, batteries have a role to play, the grid have a role to play, but offering an off-grid sort of distributed power option alternative, which gives you not only green but also availability and reliability of power, is definitely going to be part of the energy mix into the next decade.
And how's the competition now?
Well, I mean, we were certainly the first to announce the EV charger utilising a fuel cell. You know, I think since then there's been a couple of others that have started to look at it. I guess it's not, we're not just competing against fuel cell technologies, we're competing against alternative green energy generation. And so, you know, this is part of a balanced mix of generation technologies. I think the Global Hydrogen Council, to which AFC is a part of, predict that by 2050, 18% of the world's power will be powered from hydrogen. And so we are part of that solution towards a net zero economy.
I work in film, and it's often on film set when we're putting big production together, there's a requirement for quite a lot of lighting energy. Have you considered using hydrogen for powering light systems and so on film set?
Film set specifically, no. Yeah. But in terms of sort of temporary applications, whether it's a set of a film or whether it's a festival or a sporting event, we didn't have to look too far. There's been interest coming to us on all of those levels. So I guess part of that journey is to demonstrate the system, which is what we're doing today, launching the system. We will be showcasing this across the UK into next year. We have some festival management companies, we have some sporting events, we have some diesel generator hire companies who have approached us about whether this is actually a viable technology in that application. And so wherever you have a diesel generator at the moment providing temporary power, there is a potential opportunity for us to deploy our fuel cell system.
Excellent. And last question. What are your feelings on hydrogen vehicles themselves, vehicles that run on hydrogen? How soon implemented? Do you think we'll see many on the roads in 10 years, or will there be a balance? What's your feeling on that?
Sure. I mean, I think the we're certainly supportive of hydrogen fuel cell vehicles, absolutely. And, that's, again, it's part of that journey towards a decarbonized transportation network. I think different people have different views as to the role that hydrogen vehicles will play, whether it's more long-term trucking, haulage, or shipping, or the likes. But what is clear is yes, there will be a role for hydrogen vehicles, but in the short term, the government's aspirations for deployment of electric vehicles, whether it's battery or hydrogen, is so prevalent or clear that the cost of hydrogen cars and particularly the fuel, and predominantly the fuel, which is generally a very ultra pure high grade hydrogen source, still needs to come down before that becomes part of the mainstream. So whilst electric vehicles are experiencing the growth and the exponential growth that we're seeing, there is a growing role for companies like us to do what we are doing.
Adam, thank you. That's really useful. Thank you very much.
No worries. Thanks, mate.